I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making loaded hamburgers, and I'm calling them loaded because at the end you may add a variety of things, and I'll show you a few of those. The hamburger mixture itself I would call the old-fashioned hamburger because it is a recipe that's been around a long time, and it's not just using ground beef that is seasoned with salt and pepper and then thrown on a grill. It has some elements to it that are interesting, and I think you'll enjoy the juiciness of this hamburger. What we have in this bowl is 1.5 pounds of ground beef. Now this happens to be Laura's Lean, which is 8% fat. So we're adding in 1/2 cup of quick oats. And that really helps because when you're making meatloaf or something like that, you want it to have a nice texture that is soft and juicy. And that's how the oatmeal helps. We're adding for flavor some onion. This is 1/4 cup of finely chopped onion. And we're adding some tomato juice. We have 2/3 of a cup of tomato juice. So we're just adding that in. And then we want to season this with salt and pepper. I usually measure out the salt, and for each pound of ground beef, I use 1 teaspoon of salt. But here I'm just going to sprinkle it. For the pepper, I like to grind that. So we have freshly ground pepper from black peppercorns. Then I'm going to take a potato masher because that will break apart the ground beef, and when I get it broken apart, then I will use my hands to form it into patties. And my plan is to have 6 good-sized patties from this mixture. After I mixed up the hamburgers, I needed to form them into 6 patties, and I wanted them fairly equally sized. So I just divided it into 2 parts and each of those parts into 3 parts. And that's the easiest way to do that. Then I have these nice shapes with these lines down them, and you might be wondering, how did I get that? Well, it's a hamburger press, and you just put your hamburger in there and press this down. It goes out to the edge and it makes these all the same height, and it puts that little line in it. So these are ready to be cooked in a skillet or broiled in the oven or grilled outside. We haven't done grilling outside for a while, and it's nice weather today, even though it's in the winter. So Rick is going to take these outside and grill them for us, and I'll try to give you the shot of the outside in just a minute, but we'll meet back in here and put our hamburgers together. I've just stepped out to the deck where Rick is working on the hamburgers. So those are going to be great, I'm sure. And while I'm out here, I thought I would just give you a view of our countryside around where we live. Here is what we have in the distance. And right straight in front of me at this point, you can see Eastern Kentucky University, and that is where Rick and I met. That's where we attended college, and that's where we both had our careers. So we could still see it, even being retired. You might have seen Remy scampering around. He's around here somewhere. But this is Kentucky in the winter. And we'll have our hamburgers ready, and I'll meet Rick in the kitchen in just a minute to continue. Rick has been grilling the hamburgers and they're done. So this is to our taste. I like them a little more well done than he does. So he may have made a few that are a little pink on the inside and then a few that are just solid brown because of me. But you just grill them any way you like them for hamburgers. But we have 6 hamburgers. Old-fashioned variety, and I've been here in the kitchen getting together some toppings for these hamburgers. Now in the center of my table here, I have the previous 2 videos. The last video that we did was green bean fries. So it's like French fries, only they're made from green beans. So it's a little healthier. And they're to be dipped in this wasabi green onion dip. So these two were not cooked today, but you may have seen them already. So what we're going to do is assemble a hamburger. And I have buns here. These are pretzel buns. So I'm going to take one of those and put it on this plate and open it up, and you can see it looks like this on the inside. If you like it toasted, then I would suggest that you spread with softened butter and then just put it upside down on the skillet on the stove, low heat, watch it continuously, and then bring it off and then assemble your hamburger. This is going to be Rick's hamburger, so I'm going to let him choose what he wants. Which of these would you want on here?
Smoky horseradish.
The horseradish, so the one that I had prepared, kind of guessed that that would be it. And you want it on both sides?
No.
Just one side,
it's
bottom side.
Powerful.
Okay, so I'll just go around.
That's good.
Okay. And then I'll turn it back up so you can see what it really looks like. And then what I have is cheese, bacon, tomatoes, and lettuce. With the cheese, I have some hot habanero cheese, and then I have some extra sharp white cheddar. Do you want either of those or both?
White cheddar with this.
Okay, so we'll take one slice. These are very thin slices. Do you want more than one slice? Just one slice. And then do you want bacon?
No.
No bacon? He's much better at watching calories and fat and stuff like that than I am.
Yeah, that's me.
Want a tomato slice?
And lettuce.
And lettuce. And that would be the dressings he has chosen for his hamburger, which has turned into a cheeseburger now. And this one looks like it might be a little thicker in the center and more to his taste. So we'll just put it on top right there and close this. And then would you like some green bean fries? I actually stuck these in the microwave. They were made today.
That's good.
Okay. And I guess you want this. You want it to the side to dip into. Okay, so we'll just put it right here. So I hope you enjoy this. Rick will be taking a bite in just a minute.
Betty always likes to cut down the middle and show you the inside, so I'll do that too. This is a thick burger. There you go. It's not exactly pink, which they say it shouldn't be pink for hamburger anymore, but it's, I think it's still on the lesser side than the well done. So I want to give it a try if I can get that in my mouth. Well, I'd say it's an excellent burger. This horseradish sauce is really quite spicy. I guess I'm getting old. My taste buds are thinning out. I like the big taste. I always did, but I particularly do the older I get. But the burger itself is moist. It's substantial. The onion is nice. I can't tell there's any oatmeal in there. I know I saw it go in, so I know it's there. But it's just a filler. I guess is it a binder, Betty?
Yes.
A bit of a binder, but it's a nice addition, I think, and it's a nice burger. This makes a wonderful meal. It would be a great meal for the Super Bowl. You can eat it and not have to pay too much attention to your hands or your plate while you're eating. So maybe if I'm lucky, I'll have it. And I hope you enjoy this recipe.